Hello dear students, and Pratibha, I welcome you all to this video. Today we are solving another case study based question from Baye'S theorem, class 12, CBSE. The question is, the reliability of a COVID PCR test is specified as follows. Of people having COVID, 90% of the test detects the disease, but 10% goes undetected. Of people free of COVID, 99% of the test is judged COVID negative, but 1% are diagnosed as showing COVID positive. So from a large population of which only 0.1% have COVID, a person is selected at random, given the COVID PCR test, and pathologist reports him as COVID positive. Based on the above information, answer the following questions. First is, what is the probability of the person to be tested as COVID positive, given that he is actually having COVID? A is 0.001, 0.1, 0.8, 0.9. Question 2, what is the probability of the person to be tested as COVID positive, given that he is actually not having COVID? 0.01, 0.99, 0.1, 0.001. Third question, what is the probability that the person is actually not having COVID? 0.998, 0.999, 0.001, 0.11. Question number 4, what is the probability that person is actually having COVID, given that he is tested as COVID positive? 0.83, 0.0803, 0.083, 0.089. What is the probability that the person selected will be diagnosed as COVID positive? 0.01, 0.1, 0.089, 0.089, 0.189, 0.189. These are 5 parts, so we'll go one by one. Let us read the question again mindfully. For people having COVID, 90% of the test detects the disease, but 10% goes undetected. For people free of COVID, 99% of the test is just COVID negative, but 1% diagnosed as showing COVID positive. From a large population of which only 0.1% have COVID, 1% is selected at random. Given that COVID PCR test, the pathologist reports him or her as COVID positive. So certainly this question is based on Baye'S theorem. I'm not writing whole formula. Here, there are 2 subsets. One is E1, where it is a set of people having positive, COVID positive. E2 is COVID negative. And they make the whole sample space. It will be better if we write this one. And A is tested positive. Given positive. Either reported positive. Anything. Reported positive. Or it is actually positive. It is actually positive. Now, what is probability of E1? E1 is your this one. 0.1 have COVID. 0.1 have COVID. That means this is 0.1%, or this will be 1/1000. And if these are the COVID positive, then what will be the COVID negative? This will be 1 - 1/1000. 999. This one. So P1, E2 we have got. Now probability of A from E1. That means probability of tested positive when actual positive, actually positive. This is your 99%. 99% test directs the disease, detects the disease. That means this is your 9500. And probability of tested positive when there is no positive or they are negative. So this is tested positive or reported positive, and actually they don't have the disease, negative. That will be how much? This is equal to, see this part, of the people free from COVID. That means they are negative. 99% is just COVID negative, but 1% shows the disease. So that will be your 1/100. So now these four things are needed to solve the problem. PE1, 1/1000. PE2, 999/1000. A, condition E1, 90/100. A, condition E2, 1/100. So now I think you can solve the questions. So let us go for the question part one. So let me write what we have got. PE1 is equal to 1/1000. PE2 is equal to 999/1000. PA, condition E1, is equal to 90/100. PA, condition E2, is equal to 1/100. What is the probability that one person is tested as COVID positive, given that he is actually having COVID? So this is nothing but your PA, condition E1. Positive is there and tested is positive. So A, condition E1. So A, condition E1 is how much? 90/100. 90/100 means how much? 0.9. So what is the answer? D is answer of this part. Next, so part one, 0.9 is the answer. Now coming to question number two, what is the probability of the person to be tested as COVID positive given that he is actually not having COVID? That means the question is about P, condition A, condition A2, not having COVID but showing positive. So we have already written PE1 is equal to 1/1000. PE2 is equal to 999/1000. PA, condition E1 is 90/100. And PA, condition E2 is 1/100. This is 1% diagnosis COVID positive, free from COVID. From negative, it is showing positive. So 1 by 100 means it is 0.01. So what is the answer? A is answer of this question. Next. So part 1 is D, this is A. What is the probability that person is actually not having COVID? Person is not actually having COVID. So what is this is? That means this is your PE2. PE2 is, we have got it, 99/1000. So which one is the answer? 0.999. So B is answer, B, not C. PE2, not having COVID. And how many of having COVID? PE1, it will be. Next. So this is D, this is 1, this is your C. What is the probability that a person is actually having COVID given that he is tested positive? This is a tricky question. So I am writing again for your P1. How much PE1 is? P2 is 99/1000. PE1 is equal to 90/100. PE2 is 1/100. Now, what is this part? This is your P. Positive is already there. What is the probability? It is from the E1. He is tested positive, E by E1. You know how to write this? This is A open E1 to P1 whole divided by sample space. E2. So what is the answer? It will be A by E1. A by E1 is equal to 90/100 multiplies your 1/1000 100 into 1/1000 plus your 1/100 into 999/1000. One simplification, I am simplifying here. It will be, I'll take 1, this portion from both numerator and denominator, here it will be 90, here it will be 90 plus 999. This will be cancelled, it will be 90/1089. It will cancel, you will get 0.083. So C is answer of this part. Now coming to last part. What is the probability? So let me check the answers here. It was B, it was D. What is the probability the person selected will be diagnosed as COVID positive? That means this is your whole sample space. Whole sample space means it will be P A by E1 into P E1 plus P A by E2 into P E2. So the answer will be 99/100 into 1/1000 plus 999/1000 into 1/100. So in the same way, they have both the denominator is same. So 1089 upon how much? 1 lakh. So you can convert it to decimal, this will be 01089. So B will be the answer of this question. So thank you for subscribing. Thank you very much. Thank you for watching. Again, we meet in another video.